All right, everybody, we're shopping for some wonderful pork chops. They have a large selection of meat today. There's grass-fed, there's organic. Isn't it beautiful how they display all the meats and special cuts? This is absolutely beautiful. So we're going to get some pork chops and we're going to go home. We're going to fry them and we're going to smother them in gravy. See you there.
Back, everyone. Today we're going to make some smothered pork chops. They're easy to make, and these are the ingredients that you need. You will need some all-purpose flour, and you can put in it whatever type of seasoning that you like. We're going to use this flour to flour our meat, plus we're going to use it to make the gravy. You will also need 2 cups of a vegetable stock, or you can use chicken stock. And you will need some good pork chops. You can put whatever type of seasoning that you want on your pork chops. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get our grease hot. Get our grease nice and hot. Put this aside.
Chops up, then drop them in your oil and cook them to your likeness. We like our meat cooked well done, so I'm going to be cooking mine a little bit longer than usual. But you cook your pork chops to your desired cooking preference. I am cooking on 350 degrees.
Everybody, our pork chops are done. They're nice and cooked. So what you want to do is you want to remove the pork chops. Remove them from the pan. Then the next thing you want to do is, now this is obviously too much grease. So what you want to do is you want to pour some of this grease off. Put on fire down. This is coconut oil. This is coconut oil. And you see the drippings that is left in the pan? That makes a very, very good gravy. So I would say I have about maybe 1/3 cup of oil in here. I'm just estimating. And the next thing you can do, then I am taking 1/3 cup of the flour, that the batter that we use to batter our meat, and I'm going to make a gravy with it. So what you want to do is put a little in the oil and move it around. For a little extra flavor, I like to use this browning seasoning, and you don't have to. I just use this in our gravy, but it's really, really tasty also. Hooray, everybody, the gravy is ready. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take our fried pork chops and you're going to add them to the gravy. And what we're going to do after we add them, we're going to cover them and we're going to let them simmer.
Let them simmer for about a good 15 to 20 minutes. Hey guys, these pork chops are smelling good. They're almost ready because my husband is taking me on a double date with some friends of mine. We're going to an Irish pub called the Stout Snub, and we're going to listen to some bluegrass music. Her son plays in a band with the Kimballs. It's a married couple, and he plays the banjo and sometimes the electric guitar. So after this meal, check out the Stout Snub. All right, everybody, our food is all done. I would like to pray over this food, and then we all gonna head out on our date today to the Stout Snub. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for a glorious day that you have given us. Thank you for breath in our bodies and loving us. Thank you for your mercy and your grace. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for being our Lord and Savior. And we ask, Jesus, that you come into our hearts. We make you our Lord and Savior. And we thank you in your precious name, Jesus. Amen. Amen. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe.
When he dreams of memories and comfort stay. Comfort stay. Touching you.